fighting.
You fucking heard
what
that.
What the fuck is going on here?
Stand behind the line. Oh my god.
Some will fade and some will shine. Aiming for the goal.
We again, we
been trying hard to sell your soul. Oh, so many times before. No one's buying.
Necromancy is the practice of black magic involving communication with the dead. This is done by summoning spirits as apparitions, visions, or even raising someone's physical body back from the dead. Usually performed by a witch, it's used as a means to tell the future, discover knowledge that has been lost in time, or to weaponize the dead. This week, we are at a remote hunting cabin in northern Canada belonging to a man named Thomas. Thomas inherited this cabin in the early 2000s, and it's been passed down his family for generations. We first became aware of Thomas and his cabin after he posted an eerie trail cam image on Instagram. The post has since been deleted, but a screenshot shows what appears to be a ghostly little girl in the middle of the woods near the cabin. When we contacted Thomas and asked him about the photo, he said he didn't know what to make of it. He's not a believer in the paranormal, but does admit that it's very strange. There are hardly any other people in the area, let alone children, and it makes no sense why a child would be this far in the woods by herself in clothing that is not suitable for winter. When we asked him if he has had any strange experiences around the cabin, he told us that it's usually his visitors that have strange experiences while visiting. An ex-girlfriend of his who he brought to the cabin had to leave in the middle of the night after having the worst night terror of her life and didn't feel safe in the cabin. During a hunting trip with his hunting buddies, after retiring to the rooms for the night, one friend was woken by a loud noise in the upstairs bedroom where he was sleeping. After sitting up in bed, he saw an apparition standing at the edge of his bed, which quickly dissipated into nothingness. Thomas told us that he hasn't experienced anything like this inside of the cabin, but he has had a few strange experiences outside of the cabin that have creeped him out. He says that while chopping wood, he regularly gets a horrible feeling that somebody is watching him from the tree line. In the morning, he notices his shed door has been opened, which he knows he closed the night before. When inspecting the open door, the place is infested with raccoons. He also told us the story about hearing a knock on his window late at night. He grabbed his rifle to chase the culprit away, but no one was there. He did, however, see a fresh set of footprints in the snow outside of his window, with no tracks going towards or away from his window. We asked him more about the history of his cabin to get an idea of why these strange events could be occurring, and he told us that his great aunt on his mother's side used to come here and practice witchcraft decades ago, against the rest of his family's wishes. Over the years, the cabin fell into dilapidation and disrepair as the rest of the family stopped going to the cabin. However, after many years, the cabin was moved to a new spot and restored to new condition by Thomas and a few other family members. Even though the cabin has been moved and restored, it seems to be haunted by its history of black magic and necromancy.
Well, my name is Johnny and this is Jordan. You can touch that thing if you want. Are we talking to a witch?
Well, we heard that a witch used to come here to summon spirits. Maybe some of you are still attached to this building. That's what we've heard. Whoa.
Is this door, this door or that door?
It's this back door, yeah, with this door. Hello? Radio.
Can you come? Somebody in here? That's a REM pod.
We did get a lot of activity right in the beginning of the night. We heard the knocking at the door and then the radio going off, which Jordan mentions in the video. But we didn't actually hear the bathroom light flick on. We just heard the fan start going. And that's kind of what drew our attention to it. But you'll watch now in the video again. The bathroom light was actually turned off in the beginning of the scene. So I don't really know how to explain that.
Can you touch it again? That was weird. Can you touch it again? Why did it just go on and off like that?
Who is here? Can you use the ovulus and tell me?
Abyss.
Oh, thank you.
Were you conjured by the witch that used to come here?
Yes.
I think it might be a yes.
Is the witch still around?
Whoa.
That's a big yes. Are we in danger by being here? Yes, whoa. We're in danger. Oh, man. Okay. It's a big yes.
Is she outside?
Okay, can you let go for a second? Let go. Let go. Thank you. Is the witch the one that knocked on the door?
Sort of noise.
Yeah, I know, I heard it too.
I never mentioned it or voiced it to Jordan in the moment because every time the activity started, it seemed inconvenient to mention it.
And he never mentioned it to me, but he didn't know that I was also experiencing it, that every time the activity ramped up in that place, I just caught a very faint smell of
food and
like old grease.
Hours. Oh my God. Quake pod? I hear something up here. There it is! I hear something up here.
Hello? You know what's on it?
That thing's going off down there too! Okay, can you let go of that for a second so we can communicate? We can use devices to communicate. Oh, I'm freaking out.
The first few hours that we were there, we didn't get a lot of activity until Thomas left, which was amazing to us because Thomas, by all accounts, had no real experiences inside the cabin while he was there. And that really seemed to ring true because once he left, we immediately started getting a flurry of activity. We started getting all kinds of REM pod action and my mic pack just randomly died. So that being said, we will subtitle the rest of the scene so you know what I'm saying.
Searching, yeah, we are searching for you, but we just want to communicate.
We just want to talk. You let us know that, okay, thank you.
Wow.
Please let go of it.
Let go of it completely. Just let go, or make it go cold.
Sometimes you guys might hear us on an investigation say make it go cold, and basically all that means is the light on the REM pod is green, and if we want it to go cold, it'll turn blue, and if we want it to go hot, it'll turn red, so that's basically all that means.
Who are you?
I'm hearing stuff all over, all around me.
Do you know the witch? Is that a yes?
Can you move it anywhere? It keeps going off.
Once we started getting REM pod activity, I moved it all over the cabin and it seemed to follow us wherever it went. However, it still seemed that the most amount of activity that we got was in the kitchen next to the wood stove.
Are you done? Do you know anything about a witch?
Wow, okay. That was very good response. Is she here with us right now? Okay.
Is this like a B for yes thing?
Are we, can you stop? Okay, stop.
Please stop.
Turn it off.
That was so weird. It was kind of like every time we asked a question, like boom.
Yeah, like exactly. If you're still here, you can light up a different REM pod. Like there's a couple of different ones, and there's one upstairs.
What do you know about a witch that you should practice here?
It was me.
She was a recluse. Is that why she came here, to be away from her family? They knew what she was doing. Where's that other REM pod?
Right here.
Can you touch that one? We're here because a man named Thomas told us about the story. Do you know anything about him?
This weird feeling that that one downstairs is going to go off for like any second.
70.
Soul. Soul. Reply
again.
You fucking heard
what?
That.
Going on, dude. Violence.
Violence?
Soul.
Soul. Revive. You fucking heard
what?
That.
Violence!
I was already creeping up the stairs thinking that something would peek out at me as I walked up the stairs, but then I heard a flurry activity downstairs and absolutely everything in my body just froze and I couldn't move, I couldn't speak. All I could say was, what the fuck, what was that? And when I got downstairs, I saw everything moving and...
I mean, how the fuck would you explain it, right? No? You turn around and everything's moving. The light's moving, the guitar. I didn't even know the guitar was turned around right away. Jordan, I looked at it and Jordan was like, yeah, it turned around. I was noticing the coffee table. I don't know. It's one of those things. We don't want any violence. We're just here to film.
Can you move this guitar back? Flip it around.
Oh, that's the wrong way.
Look at that. It wasn't like that. Can you flip it back around for me? Or turn the flashlight off.
Idiot.
Fuck you. Turn it around, please.
Do it again. Let's go. Oh, dude, I gotta get out of here.
Yeah, me too.
We're gonna go for a smoke, and can you change everything back by the time we come back in? I got a bad feeling in here, dude. There it goes. Just as I said that. Right there. I gotta get out of here, man. As soon as I said that, I don't feel good.
As soon as I said that I felt sick or ill or whatever, the REM pod went off immediately, and this was the moment where I knew the night was gonna turn around and it was not gonna be good.
I fucking hate, it's fine, like, getting a buildup of energy and all that,
yeah.
But once it starts getting like that, where you get everything really moves. The coffee table was moved.
What do you think that means, though?
I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know.
Like, what kind of shit was she like messing with?
And the thing is, the cabin was moved from somewhere.
It was very quickly becoming apparent that we had no idea what we were dealing with, and we were not equipped to deal with what was coming after us.
As far as witchcraft goes and all that, I don't honestly know. I don't know how witchcraft works in the occult. That's something I don't ever want to dive myself into. I don't want my family to be involved with it, nothing like that.
We know that this place had been moved from another spot many years ago, maybe to escape the past that this cabin had with Thomas's great aunt practicing witchcraft. Maybe they thought that moving it to a different place would cleanse it and it would give it a fresh start, but that clearly is not the case.
What's that?
Do not. I probably shouldn't have came here in the first place, right?
Oh my god. Okay.
Holy shit.
Oh my god, I'm having a panic attack here.
But I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go, up or down.
You hear that? Wait. Shh. I keep hearing things like. Sounds like movement.
I heard movement the last hour. Probably shouldn't have came here in the first place, right?
Oh my god. Okay.
Holy shit. I didn't know really what was happening at that second because we were walking back downstairs, but
I turned to my right and then looked back.
And that's when I looked between the railings and I saw the chair that was just on one side of the room was already on the other side of the room and it was rocking back and forth. That's clockwise.
Oops. L or M?
M? A.
You hear that?
Yep.
R. Oh man, it looked like he was gonna. Mary.
Are you good or are you bad?
Holy
oh my god! Holy shit. Okay. Oh. I don't even know. Who is that? You have no idea how terrifying it was doing the Ouija board session and then the cup fell what sounded like, I thought it was right beside me. And I wanted to, like, let it go and run away like I did in Hangman's Church Part 1, but I knew better this time. And Johnny and I, we said goodbye, and we had to go outside. And when we got outside, the dog on the property was going absolutely nuts. And I still didn't feel safe because, just like Thomas, I had also felt that somebody had been watching me from the tree line ever since we pulled up.
Hi. Okay. I was a knock at the door.
I'm gonna check that. Okay, Mary, can you say goodbye?
Again? Okay, goodbye. No.
Mary, we have to say goodbye now, okay?
I'll just put it there. Goodbye. Just okay. Put it there.
Okay. Ooh.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Dog is going nuts. And that creeps me out because he says he can feel somebody watching him from the tree line.
That's the cold rampart.
It's cold. Get the camera. Oh, it's going back. It's going back. Oh, just missed it. Oh,
can you do that again? Oh, the dog's barking and everything. Are you in here right now? Freaking out. Do it again, please. Oh, I'm pissed off. Hang on, I gotta take this. There it goes. Thank you. Oh, man.
Did we let
Can you make it go back to normal now? Can you make it go? Thank you. Holy shit.
Oh my god.
It's going hotter. The noise. Wait, no.
There was a shuffling. I heard a shuffling.
No, I heard a beep. That I heard too, but I heard a weird beeping noise. There it goes again.
Did we let something else in when we opened the door?
I don't know. What dog did it say? Mary? Did it just say Mary?
Mary. Wait, Mary?
Not Mary.
Mary.
There it goes again. Right when you said that.
I know Johnny has heard beeps on the spirit box before.
Gentle.
Calming. Coming or calming or something?
Calming, gentle. So that doesn't sound like you.
Oh, it said we.
We? So it sounds there is more than one? Is there two?
Yes.
Yes?
Oh my god. Steven.
Is one of you good and another one bad? Are you both bad? Are you both good?
We again. We.
We. Okay.
Mary.
It said Mary.
Where's your stone?
I didn't bring it.
You don't have it here?
I didn't bring it.
Thank you.
What the fuck did I say? Mary? Did you say Mary?
Mary. Wait, Mary?
Not Mary.
Mary.
There it goes again. Right when you said that.
I know Johnny has heard beeps on the spirit box before.
Gentle.
Calming. Coming or calming or something?
Calming, gentle. So that doesn't sound like you.
Oh, it said we.
We? So it sounds there is more than one? Is there two?
Yes.
Yes?
Oh my god. Steven.
Is one of you good and another one bad? Are you both bad? Are you both good?
We again. We.
We. Okay.
Mary.
Said Mary.
Where's your stone?
I didn't bring it.
You don't have it here?
I didn't bring it.
This door or that door?
It's this back door, yeah, with this door. Hello?
Radio.
Radio.
Heard
what
that.
The fuck is going on, dude?
Violence.
Violence.
Violence?
This is the only robot we haven't seen. We've heard it a couple times.
And you know what's funny? It's actually touching the roof pretty well. So if it doesn't go off, if it doesn't go off that close to something. Mm-hmm.
About like
it has to be like your like heat, the heat from your hand, eh?
Something like that, yeah.
Do not.
What's that?
Do not. I probably shouldn't have came here in the first place, right?
Oh my god. Okay.
Are you good or are you bad?
Holy
oh my god! Are you good or are you bad?
Holy
oh my god!
I no longer need this.
I no longer need
this. I asked for the book. You have no control over me. No, I have no. You have no control over me.
You have no control over me.
I control me.
I control me.
That's right.
I control me.
I take over me.
I take over me.
I don't need you.
I don't need you.
Go.
Go.
I demand you to go.
I demand you to go. I demand you to go. I demand you to go. If you've watched the Demons Inside episodes, you'll know that I've struggled with a demonic attachment for most of my life. Our theory is that the attachment that has been following me since I was a child grew stronger after I began investigating haunted locations and taunting other spirits last year. We think that the activity ramped up because we picked up an entity known as the Beep from Morgan's room during the audio files of a demon episode. The Beep may be an explanation for the increased activity, but we believe that the original spirit, the one that's caused the dark cloud over my life for so many years, is an entity named Mary. The name Mary has come through the ovulus and spirit box numerous times throughout our investigations. and we've begun to suspect a woman named Mary has been following us around, and we do believe this is the entity that has been leeching off me since I was a child. It was terrifying to hear her name rear her ugly head while investigating a cabin where a witch is said to have practiced necromancy. And it makes me think, what a horrible night to have a curse.
Where's your stone?
I didn't bring it.
You don't have it here?
I didn't bring it.
Okay, let's do sensory. Are you okay?
Okay, yeah, I'll do it.
Are you sure? Okay, let's put some salt around you. Just all so right. That it can't come near, you know what I mean? Let's put you in a circle, just so it can't right. come near and touch you, but you can communicate.
Okay. Yeah,
let's do that.
Let's try it.
Okay.
We originally brought the salt to protect ourselves, and we were going to put it in front of the doorways because Thomas told us the story about his hunting buddy who saw somebody peeking in and peering through the windows. So that's why we brought it originally, but after Mary made herself known and we knew that she was there, I decided to tell Jordan to do a sensory deprivation, and we'd put the salt around him to protect him so that Mary could not enter the salt circle. And that's why I placed a chair in front of Jordan during the sensory deprivation, so that she could sit in front of him at least and communicate without being able to cross the circle and harm him.
Oh my God!
What do you see?
Holy fuck, I thought I saw a shadow. This... Holy shit, I thought I saw a shadow through the holes there.
That's been silent all night.
Yeah, for hours.
Right before the sensory deprivation?
As soon as we get that all set up.
Is someone trying to pull me away from it?
Well, we're doing it anyway, so come downstairs. Can you let go, please? Full focus. Oh, my hands are shaking. Okay, can you let go, please? So strange.
All right. Yeah, I remember before going into the sensory deprivation, we heard the REM pod going off upstairs. And I remember thinking that because there's obviously more than one spirit here, it's not just Mary, there's got to be more benign spirits around. I've got the feeling that what it was trying to pull me upstairs away from interacting with the malevolent one, which was Mary.
Please come blow some of these candles or move that planchette. I put a chair here so you can sit in front of Jordan, but you cannot cross this.
They're here.
Who's here? You cannot cross the salt line, but you can sit.
The ones?
I put this chair here so you can sit in front of Jordan and speak with him.
Familiar.
Familiar.
You turn.
Isn't familiar? That's a witch term. Is that a cat?
Outsider.
Outsider.
Mary, very clear.
Mary, we believe that you are the spirit that's attached.
I found you. Jordan.
Mary, do you like Jordan? Are you still with him?
Ocean.
It said yes.
Why are you here?
Pig.
Is that you, Mary?
Level.
It is you, Mary? You cannot go inside the salt.
Here, I'm here.
You cannot go inside the salt circle. You can come and sit in this chair.
Johnny.
What? Mary, let go.
Leave.
Now. Let go, Mary. Mary.
Mary again. Male's voice. You're sluts.
Come sit in this chair.
Lap.
Lap?
Evil.
No, you cannot sit on his lap. You can sit in the chair in front of him.
Coming.
What do you want? If that's you, Mary, what do you want from Jordan? You just want to be close to him, don't you?
Receive?
Okay, Mary, go away. We don't want you around us anymore.
Picture this, you know, everything that Jordan has gone through in the last 2 months that we've all been able to watch. You know, Jordan's been going through depression and had this medium session with Patty. And then for me to be watching like a fly on the wall, a chair sitting across from Jordan while he's in a salt circle, completely covered in candles. And I ask Mary to sit down in the chair and make herself known, and she does. I'm picturing a demonic entity staring at my best friend, and you know, she's looking at him directly in the eye, but she can't get to him. That's such a terrifying feeling, you know? I know she's there, and I know he's there. I mean, imagine that. Imagine being in that situation.
But there are, we're pretty like far out here, and I wouldn't say there's like kids anywhere around.
No, there's, every now and then there's a couple houses every couple miles, but yeah. Nothing crazy.
No reason why like a child would be like in the middle of the bush.
No.
Especially like middle of winter.
Yeah.
And like, you know, not wearing, you know, appropriate clothing.
Obviously.
Yeah, it was super strange. Do you believe in like ghosts, like paranormal stuff at all?
I do not.
You don't know at all?
So like what exactly about the picture was like, it was so weird that you decided that you wanted to put it out there?
Oh, I've never seen anything like it before. Didn't know what it was. And
yeah, because I mean, how often, like you were talking earlier, you said you see stuff on the trail cam that's weird, but nothing like that, right? Yeah, that creeped the shit out of me when I first saw it. We were doing drone shots all day, and we were at the lake, getting shots of the lake all afternoon. And it shows that we only entered the cabin about 25 minutes after the figure appeared in the doorway. It gets super dark up there in like northern Manitoba, like very early, especially in winter. Now, as far as what that is, I can't help. I personally believe that it is the same figure that was caught on the trail cam by Thomas, but that's just my opinion. It could have been the witch. I don't know, but I do believe that there are things that we don't understand that are wandering the nearby woods, and Thomas caught it on camera, and now we did as well.
Every now and then you get like that hard wind I was talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
I get that towards me, and then all of a sudden the fire just goes out.
You've had the fire actually go out on
you?
Oh,
yeah.
Like in the cabin?
Yeah. I thought nothing of it, they were just wind. So every time that wind comes, I feel like I'm being watched, and I got a chill on my back. It's pretty creepy. I got a dog with me. He barks every now and then when it happens, which is even more weird, because he doesn't bark at anything usually.
He's a pretty calm dog.
Pretty calm dog, yep.
Hmm. Yeah, it's super strange. You can always like rely on animals too to like know if stuff's going on.
Dog's barking out there. Freaking out.
Listen. Dog is going nuts. Because Thomas told us that his dog is usually very calm until creepy things start going on around the cabin, we thought it would be a fun experiment to have his dog with us. And Thomas has like a heated shed kind of next to the cabin where his dog stayed for most of the time. You know, we gave him food for the weekend and he had a doggy door so he could come in and out. So we had his dog there for the weekend, and Thomas just asked us to drop him off after we left. So we did. We picked him up and we dropped him off at Thomas's on the way home.
There was one night a buddy was sleeping and he saw something in front of the bed.
Do you believe that?
Oh no, I said it was a bunch of bullshit.
Why, is he just a big bullshitter or what?
Oh, 100%. That guy is brutal.
Okay. So obviously you've had some weird stuff, and like especially like other people, like your buddies have had weird stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any reason you think this stuff would happen?
Oh, my great auntie, she played with witchcraft in the cabin.
Really?
She was into that kind of stuff.
So she like witchcraft, so she would like hold like seances and stuff and try to talk to the dead. And this is like, how do you know, like this is something that you've just heard? Like,
someone's been told. Family's been telling stories, because I've been telling the family about this, and then also that got brought up.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's really interesting. So like, even knowing all of that about like your great aunt like practicing witchcraft, you still don't believe like what's going on is like ghosts or spirits or anything?
Not at all.
Not at all. No. Okay.
Well, I guess we'll do our investigation and see what we find. Thanks for letting us check out your cabin.
Oh, no problem. Yeah. Hope you find whatever that is, and yeah, no problem.
All right, man.
Doesn't it suck that fires have to like stay in one spot? Like, we could just have a fire on the way home.
That's deep, man. It's also stupid.
Like, can you imagine, though? I would love that.
Matt, ever since we got back from, what did I say?
UK. More nonsense.
It's been nonsense for hours. Ever since we got back from the lift there area.
Yeah.
And just nothing but bullshit.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't know if it's, that might be good. Might have to make a coffee soon.
Yeah.
Same.
Okay, that's kind of weird.
That is weird.
Are you getting tired too?
Yeah. You're looking very seductive, Jordan.
Hours.
The fuck was that? The fuck was that?
Whoa!
Holy fuck. What the fuck was that? There's a huge snap. And then the bang? Okay.
What the fuck is going on?
Okay, here we go. Who is here now? Can you tell me who you are?
Just like that.
Just stops.
Yeah, now it's done. What was that bang up here?
I don't know.
Oh my god.
What?
Did you hear that? That bang at the door?
What happened?
Oh, I don't know. It felt like I got pushed.
Fell down.
Oh my god.
You slipped?
I don't know. It felt like I got pushed, but it felt like somebody pushed me. Oh my god.
What happened?
Oh my god.
What?
Did you hear that? That bang at the door?
What happened?
Oh, I don't know. It felt like I got pushed.
Fell down.
Oh my god.
You slipped?
I don't know. It felt like I got pushed, but it felt like somebody pushed me. Like it felt like somebody pushed me.
Was the door open before or after you fell?
I don't know. Did you hear that noise, Jordan? Like, that grunting noise?
Yes, I did hear that.
Did that not sound like hoofs?
I didn't want to mention it, like I didn't. You done?
Yeah.
Like, are you just going to have a cigarette or?
I don't know.
Okay, let's talk about it.
Pack. What did that say?
Pack. He wants us to pack up.
That was one of the best videos I've seen in a long, long time. Man, it got me. It really did. Hey, Johnny, do you want to come over to Discord, mate, and talk about it? Is this sort of like making you shit yourself a little bit? Like, what if things attached to you? And it's also made you think...
This is weird. I like, with everything that happened, that the same night that we left there, I had really wild dreams. And then the next morning, I got super sick. I'm still sick right now, like, and I wasn't around anybody. It's just like, just deathly sick. I've been in bed for the last 2.5-3 days. And just...
this is the first real physical interaction that I've had with Mary. And it's really hard to explain. It's almost like a gust of wind came through the cabin and my legs were just swept out from underneath me. It didn't feel like hands on me. It just felt like it was just an energy around me. And the first time that I had an interaction with Mary was when we were in the RV in the Demons Inside Part 2. And right after we filmed the night in the RV, I got really sick and I was bedridden for a week. And I went on an interview with Casper Sight on his Twitch channel. And I told him about how I got sick. And after this experience at the cabin, it's just one more nail in the coffin that we know it was Mary, because I got sick immediately after that too. And I don't know what it is with Mary. It's clear that she doesn't ever want me around when she's present with Jordan, because I get sick, or now it's starting to get a bit aggressive on me. And I don't know, that's a lot to handle. So it's just something we need to take care of, I think, ultimately. Get rid of her once and for all, so we can start doing these investigations again without her being around.
Well, man, if you do want to call this one early, like, there's plenty that we got. Hear me. I've been praying every single day since this investigation that nothing has followed myself or Johnny back from this cabin. We seem to have confirmed paranormal activity happening in and around Thomas's cabin, but what was more unsettling to me was the fact that Mary forced her way back into my life in a way that may have compromised this investigation, because we're not entirely sure what was Mary and what was already the entities that were there that were summoned by the witch, or maybe they're one and the same.
Aiming for the goal, been trying hard to sell your soul. Oh, so many times before.
I'm just so sick of this black cloud following me around. It's not only messing with my life, it's messing with the lives of my family members. It attacked my best friend, and it's just sucked me into the lowest point of depression I think I've ever been, and I'm really starting to feel like there's no way out, and I just don't know how much longer I can do this for. It's especially hard because I lost my grandfather a week ago, and all I can think is I want to live my life in a way that it would make him proud if I did, especially thinking about how hard his last couple of years of life were. I want to thrive, and I want to show him that I'm capable of the man that he always knew that I was capable of becoming. And I need to get rid of this curse for him, and not only for him, for myself, for my family, for my future wife and kids. And I just hope that when I'm able to meet him again, that he can tell me how proud he is of me. I want to tell him how proud I am to be his grandson, because I never had that opportunity. And for that to happen, I think Mary has to leave once and for all.
A little over a year ago, we caught wind of a very creepy Instagram post that has since been removed from a man named Thomas. The photo was caught on his hunting trail cam in northern Manitoba, which features the image of a ghostly girl walking down the path in the middle of winter. Wearing only something that resembles a dress or a nightgown, and she doesn't appear to be wearing any shoes. Thomas didn't know what to make of it. He's not a believer in the paranormal, but did admit to strange things happening regularly in his hunting cabin near where the trail cam photo was taken. Thomas also told the stories that had been passed to him about a family member that used to practice witchcraft in this cabin at its previous location before it was moved to its current location years ago. We packed our gear and made the long drive up north to investigate Thomas's cabin in November of last year to make contact with whatever might be lingering in the cabin. We didn't know if the spirit of the witch was still here, who the ghost girl from the photo was, whether she was the witch or something the witch had conjured, but we didn't get the answers we were looking for, because something else from our past gave us an unexpected visit. I had forgotten my quartz stone for protection, and it became evident to us that Mary had tagged along and heavily interfered with our investigation. Instead of finding the answers we had come for, we spent most of our time in contact with Mary trying to get more answers from her. After this investigation, we always felt that we should go back to try to find more answers about the witch and her activity in the cabin. So this time, I made sure to bring my quartz stone with me to make sure Mary doesn't come around, so we can do a proper and uncompromised investigation of this location. Nearly a year later, we packed up our gear again, and once again made the long drive up to northern Manitoba. The last investigation here was one of the most terrifying experiences of our lives, and even though we had protection from Mary, we had a chilling feeling on the way there that this time would be no different. Oh.
And then you get like that hard wind I was talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
I get that towards me, and then all of a sudden the fire just goes out.
You've had the fire actually go out on you?
Oh yeah.
Like in the cabin?
Yeah. I thought nothing of it. They were just wind. So every time that wind comes, I feel like I'm being watched, and I got a chill on my back. It's pretty creepy. I got a dog with me. He barks every now and then when it happens, which is even more weird because he doesn't bark at anything usually.
He's a pretty calm dog.
Pretty calm dog, yep.
Hmm. Yeah, it's super strange. You can always like rely on animals too to like know if stuff's going on.
I half expect to see just somebody peeking out the window in this house.
You're not surprised me. I've seen a lot of shit in this house.
During the day, we went fishing, just waiting for the night to start. And we were in a beautiful part of the province. It was one of the last weekends that we had before it got brutally cold here. And we decided to film the entire thing because we want to show you guys more about who we are when we're not YouTubers, paranormal investigators, whatever. And it was a lot of fun. We didn't catch any fish, but we did end up making a discovery that transformed the entire investigation.
That was a bust.
Huh?
That was a bust?
Yeah. Oh well.
Not having fish for dinner. That's a fact.
We already know what we're having for dinner though.
Burgers. Well, we could have had burgers and fish.
True.
Although that's without having a boat, like going around that island would have been nice.
I bet this place is just beautiful in summer though.
My brain is telling me to grab that rock right there, but that's risky.
Get it.
Don't deny what your brain wants you to do for safety reasons.
It's so smooth.
Look at that. Oh, it is.
It's ridiculously smooth.
Nice rock, Tyler.
I started when I was 8. They got up somewhere.
You have to find all your old rocks just to put one in the collection.
Yeah. Probably only like 2 or 3 in there anyway.
3 very smooth rocks.
Yeah.
They're my rocks. That?
Huh? What is that?
What is this? Old washrooms? Is it?
Definitely just here. Well.
What? Oh my god. That's creepy.
Probably just some over here. Alright, see it over there.
Still weird though. It's way out here. It's just broken. That's creepy.
Yeah, definitely creepy.
What was that?
I know, it's just a bang. I thought it was from like the other side.
You f***ing tripped over. Is there a bird in here?
Hello?
Sounded like this. Where did it come from inside?
I thought it came from the outside here. It's echo.
Come in here and do a sensory deprivation? What?
I'm hearing like banging from over there now. Twice.
I wish you had the K2 or anything.
Hello? Maybe it's just the wave. Still hurt if you landed on it. Yeah, there it is again.
Oh, banging. It sounds almost identical to what that was.
Yeah. That's scary.
Yeah.
It makes you wonder though, like, this is the like exact spot you'd think somebody would catch a picture like that on a on a trail cam. It's still dense forest for like 3 hours back home.
Yeah. And it's so dark, there's just no house lights, street lights, anything. Even like very many other headlights. It's just dark out here.
It's not like somebody hammering. Because nobody hammers like, dude. Plus, I think it's just lakefront. Like, just like water and bush. Like you said, maybe it's like waves pushing up on like a dock or something.
That doesn't explain what we heard.
No.
It's definitely, we weren't even near the water.
And the pentagram in there?
Yeah. Well, we're gonna have to pass by that thing one more time, see if we hear anything else.
Oh, I could whip out the ovulus for a quick sec.
Yeah, do that. Let's do something there.
Friend? I wonder what that used to say.
I don't know, is there anything on it that you can tell?
Shepherd. Friend, shepherd.
No.
Soul?
Soul?
It said soul last time we were here.
Really?
Remember?
Right before everything.
Soul. Reviving it.
Oh, you f***ing heard
what
that.
What the f*** is going on, dude?
Soul, Frank, master. It gets going off. Is this an area where there used to be a witch, or there is a witch? I'm saying August, November. Last time we were here was November.
It was November.
Can you tell me what that sign is? What does this sign mean?
Quiet now?
Yeah, no, it's not saying anything.
Man, that banging is going off over there. I hope you guys can hear that on the camera.
What is that, man? It sounds weird, because it sounds like, it's like...
That's definitely not waves hitting the dock. That's deliberate knocking.
Closer that time. Can you tell me what this sign is?
More graffiti.
It's a sinner? What is all this stuff? It's a sinner. Gather. That definitely says sinner.
Yeah. The upside down cross for an eye.
What is with all the frickin'... The pentagram says legion and then that.
Well... Kinda wanna get out of here.
Okay, so just before we started recording, Grandpa just went nuts. That was you. Can you do that one more time? Whoa. It starts right away.
We're looking to speak to anything that might be residing here, anything related to the witch or...
Oh. Why? We've had this thing on for 2 hours. I want to go check out the guitar. So last time we were here, see, and I'm holding it to the camera. Look at this. And it's not doing anything.
So it's not. Yeah, you're holding it right to the camera.
Last time we were here, this guitar turned around on us.
Soul. Reviving it.
Oh, you f***ing heard
what
that.
What the f*** is going on, dude?
Violence.
Violence? Whoa.
Nothing.
Hold that for a second. I'm gonna get the audio going.
Okay. Nope. Something right here.
If that's you, can you let it up all the way to red?
Let me get these. This camera rolling.
Oh, it's just going to yellow. Like it's trying.
Why would it be happening here though? Cause come touch to the microwave. I did it earlier just to test.
Oh. Nothing. Oh.
Speaking of which, though, you have your stone this time.
I do, yeah. It's in my pocket right now.
Last time we were here, you didn't have that. So now we're actually going to be able to test properly.
This thing is still here. Just...
Why? Why is it doing that? It didn't do it at all for the last 2 hours.
Remove.
Remove what? Not the stone.
No, we're not doing that.
No, we're not going to do that. What do you want us to remove? Ourselves? What?
Something right here.
There's nothing around here though. What is happening? Can you give us some clear indication of what you are? Because
I'm holding it further away from myself and from the camera.
Oh my god, I just asked. Can you give us some clear indication of what you are? And it says cannot.
Cannot? Why is that?
Well, that's still going on.
Like, you literally have to touch this thing.
Put it to the microwave. Something. Watch, it's not going to do... It didn't do anything before. What do you... Like, what do you mean?
Yeah, the microwave, it should be lighting up. But over, lighting down up. Here... But there's nothing.
Hold it to the fridge. Nothing.
It's not the fridge.
There is no, and there's no Wi-Fi, nothing in here. We're in an old cabin.
Oh, now it calmed down. Same spot, no activity. Oh, it's...
Can you come touch that? That's one of our devices that you can touch if you want to.
Oh. Well, something here on the stairs again. It was really quick, though. I think it's gone. Nope.
What? Jordan.
What?
That was just going off. Now it's dead. The battery just died.
What did it say?
Strange.
That is pretty strange.
Heart strange.
Okay, this thing will not... Stop. Nope.
What? That was just going off. Now it's dead. let us know? Okay. There's a lot of questions we had from last time. Can you let us know what you are? Last time we thought it was a witch. Whoa!
Okay.
What is that? Why is it doing that? I've never seen it do that.
Are you trying to get my attention? You have my attention now.
That is very strange.
Can you answer some questions now, please? Do you know the witch that used to conjure spirits here? Before the cabin was moved?
But I'm wondering if it's not a witch. Like, what is it? Maybe with that all that shit we found out in the bush?
Yeah. Well, I'm thinking if it's something that the witch used to conjure, communicate with,
right.
That's still stuck here. I think the
witch was, like, conjuring something.
Yeah, not necessarily as the witch herself.
Is it coincidence that the cabin was ended up moving here?
Coincidence in what way?
So close to that fucking thing we found.
Yeah? You think it was closer to there, originally?
I don't know if it was supposed to be moved here, or if that came after the fact. Because whatever we had experienced out there, I feel like it's connected to this somehow.
Oops.
Oh, right when you hit that chair? What?
So in this chair?
What is happening?
Are you sitting here with us in the chair?
That was weird.
Okay. No. It's like right.
There's nothing in here. I've never seen it do that. It's redlining so hard that it can't even handle it. Can you come touch our skin somewhere?
This is the only robot we haven't seen. We've heard it a couple times.
And you know what's funny? It's actually touching the roof pretty well. So if it doesn't go off that close to something.
Mm-hmm. So I don't think
off. Mm-mm.
It's something about like
your. It has to be like your like heat. The heat from your hand, eh?
Something like that, yeah.
Do not. What's that?
Do not. I probably shouldn't have came here in the first place, right?
Oh my god. Okay. There's nothing in your pockets.
Oh, it still went a little bit.
What is going on? That is insane. Oh.
Okay, you want to sit?
Mind-boggling.
Have a conversation with us. Feel free to rock in the chair. Okay, can we play a game? Can you light it up to yellow if you know the witch that used to conjure spirits in this cabin?
That lit up to right there.
As soon as we got
Crops. A
response in the ovulus. Okay. What sort of crops? It's just a bunch of bush around here. What sort of crops did you used to grow? Come on, give me some answers.
I know. After.
Oh, that's going crazy. What did it say?
Come.
Come?
Come, yeah.
Come to the crops?
What?
What crops?
It lit up like crazy right when that happened. I'll be honest though, from what I'm gathering right now, it's whatever it is really loving you. Because I can stand far away and it doesn't do anything. If I hold it, it doesn't do anything. When you're close, it does.
It's not uncommon, I guess.
Not with everything happened last time here, though.
Okay, hold on. Where is it?
What, your crystal?
Yeah. If that's who I think you are, you cannot be here. You need to get lost. I'm only here making a video with my friend.
We?
I'm only here making a video with my friend, and I don't want you here. You can't be here.
There's no way that can be possible, though.
It's not possible. Or it shouldn't be.
Why is it that we've had all this shit going for so long? Nothing, as soon as we turn the cameras on and we're ready to go and we start trying to communicate, it's like boom, boom, boom.
Nothing.
Put it beside it. Can you touch that thing with that stone nearby?
I bet you won't.
That's wild.
I bet you won't. You can't come near me. I'm just here with my friend making this video out of curiosity. And I have no room for this negative energy. So you have to stay away.
Why isn't this thing?
There we go.
That's dead too!
That thing was like, yeah. Thing was going crazy when we tested it out. We thought it wouldn't stop.
Why is everything dying?
But look, no. Even if it's like near the K2, I have this.
Shoes. No, like by the door, we're not letting you in. Look, oh my goodness. Dead too.
That one dead too?
Everything's dying. It's dead. That's dead too. Can you touch it now? Wow, immediately when I said that. So you're basically holding that thing.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing.
So
it's been in my pocket.
It's not that I needed any more confirmation. As if the quartz that Patty gave me truly gave me any protection, because we saw the last time when we came here and I didn't bring it and so much crazy stuff happened. But what further confirmed it for me was when we were hanging around the K2 meter downstairs on the little island and we were talking, trying to get answers, but the K2 meter did absolutely nothing until I took the stone with me. I stepped away from the K2 and it immediately started going crazy.
Can you tell me your name and don't say what I think I'm gonna hear?
Whoa!
Can you tell me your name, please? Every time I ask that question. Use this. Use the ovulus. An entire pack of coyotes just stopped at once. What's going on out there?
I wonder if that has anything to do with this. It's this area. That's what I heard before.
Hello? I'm hearing like a couple of them now, really faint.
That's so weird. Whoa, what was that? A noise came from inside. That was weird.
I don't know why an entire pack of Cody's would just like dead stop like that all at once.
I know.
I don't know, yeah, exactly. Like, why would an entire pack of coyotes just kind of stop?
Dead like that?
Just stop dead all at the same time. Because I've heard them before, and they go all night. Never tell if the thing's on or off. Oh no, it's off. Yep.
What the hell's going on with these, man? It just didn't go. Hang on, I just want to check upstairs and make sure that that... That one's good. Okay, communication test number two. It's gonna be a weird one because there is not a lot of sounds that are gonna be coming through.
Something. Can you tell me who you are? Can you tell me if you were related to the witch or summoned by the witch that used to live here? Or used to stay here?
Maybe a yes, but hard to say.
Who are you?
Oh. Whoa.
What hello? Was that? I couldn't make hello? That up. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? I couldn't make that up. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Hello, who are you?
You have the airwaves to yourself. There's nothing coming through here. We might have to test and like change the frequency, speed, and all that yet.
Hello, is this...
What was that?
I was talking.
I'll have to find that out in there.
Can you repeat that? I was trying to ask you a question.
My back hurts really bad.
Back?
Yeah.
Well, sorry, I cut you off there. Can you repeat that?
Almost like I have to sit down. It actually really hurts right now. Ow. Ah, hang on.
You alright?
No. Oh. Oh.
What happened?
Oh.
You pull something?
I don't know. Ow.
Your cramp?
Oh man. Oh.
Are you doing something to Johnny right now?
Oh man, it feels like oh.
Skipping the frequency, that's weird. Are you doing something to Johnny right now?
I like it just felt like somebody's like just grabbing like your back right beside your spine and just like pressing in.
Really? Can you tell me what that was? I'll say it once again. You can't be causing us any sort of physical harm.
Nothing.
And nothing.
Oh my god, dude, that hurt. Now it's gone though.
You're just fine?
100%
fine. It's like something was just touching you in a sensitive area and then just let go and
everything's
fine?
It was like, man, here, hold it. It's like something was pushing right here so hard that it was like pushing so hard that it meant, like, literally, I sat down, didn't help, man. I had to go down to my knees and just, like, stretch my back out. Let's try another. What is that same voice?
I don't know. I can't hear anything it says.
Like, many or something? Be more clear. Please. Although it's so hard to say please sometimes when you know you're doing something bad. Now it's going crazy though.
I still can't make out any words.
I can't make anything else. Yeah, I still can't. It just sounds like nonsense there.
It's nonsense. Shut up. Leave your phone up there?
What is that? Where's your phone?
It's in my pocket. That's not my ringtone. I don't think that's your ringtone either.
Shh. This f***ing phone!
No.
Pick it up.
Hello? Hello?
It's not even plugged into anything, dude. Oh my god!
Who are you? Nothing. It just feels like I just picked up a phone before I dialed.
Is there a dial tone?
No dial tone.
Hold it to your mic.
My mic. There's no dial tone.
Can you do that again? There's no way, dude. Was that phone even here last time?
I can't remember. I don't think it was. I'm not saying it wasn't. It might have been, but I don't remember it. Okay, here's something crazy. Can you turn the rotary dial just to 1?
There was something over here.
Can you turn the dial for me? Can you, if we go back down to the spirit box, can you use that to tell me what you wanted to say? Please. Let's go downstairs. Can we do that? Wanna try that?
Yeah. I don't know, I'm freaked out, man.
Okay. I don't know if that'll work, but I'm curious.
Bring the phone.
Okay.
Bring it with. It's not connected to anything anyway.
I feel like this thing's just gonna go off in my hand.
There's no battery. Hang on. There's no battery, right?
There's no battery.
Who's that? It's weird down here now.
Oh,
I'm scared.
I'm scared. Of.
Last time we never got any communication. It was just like boom, 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 activity. Like get out.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like get out. I don't want to talk. Leave. Let's move the cameras around though, because that one outside has been facing those like tree, wherever the crops might be. It's facing that, so I kind of want to move that again.
Okay.
Just to try and get like as much coverage as possible. This shut off.
Did it stop recording?
No, the slider shut off.
Oh, the slide shut off.
Why? Why would that shut off?
Yeah, it normally just goes back and forth constantly.
It's still recording. Everything's dying and not working correctly.
Yeah, something weird is going on. Are you ready? Oh, alright. Did you know that the Ouija board didn't have any sort of demonic connotation until The Exorcist came out?
Really?
Yeah. Other than that, it was just like an oracle that would tell you your future and whatever.
Whoa.
Alright. Can you please tell me who you are?
Man, that thing.
You are with the K2 meter, but can you show us on the Ouija board?
Oh, heard that click?
Yeah, I heard it.
Placebo.
Is the Ouija board a placebo?
It sounded like... almost like socks on the floor.
Saying this is some sort of placebo that we're using right now?
It keeps doing this pattern all night.
Yeah,
is it a pattern? Are you trying to tell us something through the K2 meter? Can we say goodbye and try and move it for a sec? Yeah.
Okay, let's say goodbye.
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 We've never had this kind of reaction before. It's like you, man.
Threat.
No, we're not a threat.
We just want to talk.
Are we the threat? Right on the planchette.
Oh.
It's just sitting, whatever it is like, my belief is it's hovering around us right now and that's it. That's further away and it's still doing it. See? Look. That's over there. That'll catch it.
Yeah, there's nothing electronic nearby. Okay, let's try again.
Look, was this one dead before too?
I think that one was the best one.
Because it just went dim.
No, but that doesn't... You actually have to touch this thing.
Okay. You're going to have to let us know a little bit more. Like, this is like, we're trying to communicate, but whatever we're doing apparently is not working for you.
Hello? Check it out.
Grab the camera.
Yeah, I got it.
Oh my God.
What?
Oh.
What happened? Yeah, that definitely wasn't like that.
Oh my God.
What are you trying to tell us? Shit. What are you trying to tell us?
Okay, that responded well though, because I asked, show us something different. Right?
That's definitely different. We haven't seen that.
Hang on, I'm gonna grab the other camera. Now it's starting to pick up again. Stay up there.
Okay.
I'll bring the ovulus. K2 is still going nuts, and there's no electronics down here now.
Please tell me who you are. Use the ovulus. We have the ovulus going right now. You can say your name.
I'm going to put it on the bed. It said Asian.
Okay, similar. Similar.
That's now it's going off again, though. Similar? Whoa. Yes, that was recording.
It was recording?
Yeah, it would have caught it. Yeah.
Okay.
Caught that.
Good. Okay.
Oh my God, my heart's racing. Thank God that was recording. I almost didn't press record on that.
I want to see that like ASAP, but I don't even know what to ask anymore. It's like, I feel like I'm asking the same thing over and over. And you're getting no answers. Megan.
Do you want us to come out to that spot that we found earlier? I wonder if that has anything to do with this.
You know, it might. I wonder if that's... We never really got the location of the trail cam.
No, we didn't.
From Thomas, but... I wouldn't... No, but you wouldn't... I don't know. You wouldn't put a trail cam near there but maybe this is where, or that's where the cabin was moved from originally. That's the only thing I can think of. And if it has any sort of relevance or any sort of connection, that's the only thing. You wouldn't have a hunting, like a trail cam right by the beach where people regularly visit. That doesn't make any sense. Especially from the hunter's perspective, because you're going to get all sorts of bullshit of people just walking by it, like,
oh, yeah.
While they're just on the beach, you know?
Back out there, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. Further south.
Oh.
Just went again. Whoa!
Okay. Can you line it up to red if you're evil? Let's cut to the chase here. Oh!
There it is.
That's okay. Okay.
It's going to red.
It's here. Like it's only what it's only after I asked, are you evil? And now it's doing this.
Are you done now?
Oh my god.
Can't go. I can't.
Where were they? They were... that's loud, man.
Thought there was one in my room here.
Oh, yeah, here.
Yeah. Turn it off.
I didn't even touch it, dude.
I thought you, like, pushed the button or something.
I was going to go reach in, and it's...
Or you, like, pulled it out, like, a battery out or something. What the hell?
This is off, too. No, that's still on. It scared me. Holy shit, dude! There's another one right here. I wouldn't have touched that when it shut off.
Does that work? Oh, yeah, there it is again.
Yeah, they all work. So why did they all shut off at the same time? You know what I mean? Why would they turn on and why would they shut off at the exact same time?
I don't know.
If I touched that one downstairs, if it was a fluke, this one wouldn't have shut off too.
Yeah, that would have kept going. I don't know, man.
Was that you?
No, well, it obviously...
Quiet. I can hear the K2's dead quiet. Oh, there it went off once. That's really weird. That was so loud.
I know, I almost have a headache now.
Was that you that set those off? Is that a ward?
I kind of want to get outside for a bit and just collect my thoughts, honestly.
Okay, well, let's leave the cameras rolling inside.
Yeah.
You should.
That was weird.
Yeah, I'm still trying to make sense of everything. Okay, let me ask you this though. Like, have we, because I don't feel now that Mary is here.
No.
This is something else. And I think in this place, from that witch conjuring spirits in this house before it was moving, it's still here. That's my honest opinion. And they don't, and they don't know who we are. They just want us to leave. So they just keep, like, trying to get us to leave.
All I know is I could sleep on one of those hammocks tonight and be fine out here.
Out here?
I hate being in there. Oh, man. What was that? A cow?
It's a cow.
There's no farm.
I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if there was cows around here, but I haven't seen one.
When I was doing drone shots, I never saw a farm. I'll have to check back, but I'm gonna put pants on real quick.
Oh yeah, I don't know how you don't already have pants on. It's cold. You made it come in with you?
No,
you good?
I'm fine.
You good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I never noticed those little red goats on the door.
No?
No, these ones?
I noticed those, yeah.
This one too?
With these ones?
No, this one. There's two there. Then there's one there.
I never
noticed that one.
I don't think that was there.
That had to have been. If the other ones were there, then it had to have been. I guarantee it.
Hold on. There was one on the fridge.
Where?
There was one on the fridge earlier. It's always been there. It was there last time. No, man. There was one on the fridge.
Why would there be two on the outside then and one on the inside?
Why would there be one on the inside of the door?
I don't know.
That makes sense.
If there was one on the two on the outside, why wouldn't there be? Right?
I guess, but I've really thought there was never one on the inside of the door. And I thought there was one on the fridge.
Well, look back then. Or go
Johnny.
Or watch
what? Johnny.
What?
I'm not touching this till you get here. Okay. What do you see?
What?
The cards right there.
What, that?
Yeah, those, it's 666 right there. I have not touched this since I played this hours ago.
So, what?
So why, okay, look. Do you know how to play solitaire?
No.
Okay, there's no reason I would have never put this there. Three offsuit sixes in a row like this. You know what I'm saying? Look, there's one missing there that's supposed to be
okay.
Red 7, black 6. That's the black 6 that was supposed to be there. There's no reason for that to be there. I would have never done that.
I don't know. That's weird.
Would a camera have caught that? Because I want to see that.
Because this one isn't facing here. This is facing there. Well, actually, I don't know. It depends when it happened. When's the last time you played solitaire?
Well, it was like it was like 5 hours ago.
You know what? If I'm gonna look back, because if there's nothing there,
that should
be empty when we were fishing.
I'm pretty sure that nothing was there. I don't know when it would have moved. I think it moved, but I don't know when.
I just don't remember seeing it. I just remember seeing... Revoked. I just remember seeing the ones on the outside, and that's the first time I saw them, because there's that goat that is like... that we saw last time here, remember? Imagine if that goat was standing outside right now. Fast.
Okay, but you don't remember seeing that goat magnet on the fridge?
No. The only thing, like...
I those, swear, man.
Like, I saw those, and I just remember that goat from last year. That's what, kind of what just reminded me of it. But then, thinking about all the, like, that demonic crazy shit or whatever, then it's like, okay, well, goat.
So it almost seems like, you know, here's a crazy thought. It might not be true, but it almost seems like he's inviting it.
Like he is? Thomas?
Yeah, with all, like, the goat imagery and stuff like that. Is it just kind of like a, you know, like a middle finger almost? Like, you know?
Like inviting us here and then this kind of shit?
Yeah.
You know why you're thinking that? Because the killer's journal.
Yeah, maybe. He probably wasn't.
I'll be back. I gotta go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
We're gonna come back to that spot in the bush. Can you let me know if you want me there? Well, at least I'm coming back. Quiet. I'm not going to be able to put this one away unless I go back. We're going to come back and we're going to be in complete darkness. We're going to bring only night vision, I think.
Yeah.
You're gonna hate me.
Oh no.
We gotta go back.
Yeah?
To that spot.
And do what?
A sensory.
Where?
By those bathrooms where that pentagram was.
By the bathrooms or in the bathrooms?
In it. I know you're not gonna like that one. But not only that, I want to go like all night vision. It's like total dark.
Okay, if we're doing... I don't have a problem with the night vision, but... What do you think we'll find there? What's your...
I don't know. I thought my thought process was like closure of maybe that's something like that spot has to do with the picture.
So I feel like that's just some like, you know, some teenager or whatever just like... did some graffiti pentagram on the...
Okay, so then what was that noise then?
I don't know. That I don't know.
If you don't want to go back, I'll do it alone, but...
Do we have to find out?
We should.
We should.
It'd be the right thing to do.
What do you expect to find out?
All I know is it's away from here, and it's over there. I just did another walkthrough with the K2 and there's nothing going on. Okay, so I feel so like chasing it maybe over
is
there.
Is it away from here better?
I don't know. So if it's away, know, if, fine. If it's away from here, that's fine. We'll go over there and then just it'll stay there, hopefully. I knew you weren't going to like it.
But there are, we're pretty like far out here, and I wouldn't say there's like kids anywhere around.
No, there's every now and then there's a couple houses every couple miles, but Yeah. Nothing crazy.
No reason why, like a child would be like in the middle of the bush.
No.
Especially like middle of winter.
Yeah.
And like, you know, not wearing, you know, appropriate clothing, obviously. Yeah, it was super strange. Do you believe in like ghosts, like paranormal stuff at all?
I do not.
You don't?
Not at all.
So like what exactly about the picture was like, it was so weird that you decided that you wanted to put it out there?
Oh, I've never seen anything like it before. I didn't know what it was. And...
this is almost a bad idea.
I don't like it.
Ow, watch out.
I'm like trying to fight with this backpack.
What is that? What am I seeing? What is that? What is that? Oh, that's a sign. Oh, that freaked me out, dude. Did that freak you out?
Okay, what sign is it though?
That's that no jumping or whatever sign, I think.
Okay.
You ready?
Oh yeah.
And hold this.
Hold what?
I'll grab the Nikon. I'm gonna be able to look through and check the audio.
Okay, hold on. I don't think I want to do this.
Why?
Actually.
Why?
Because I'm already freezing cold.
We have to.
Man, I don't want to do it.
Why?
I'm freezing cold and I'm kind of freaking out.
I'm gonna have to do it alone then.
Huh?
Then I'm gonna have to do it alone. Don't do it.
Man, I don't know if I can do this. I'm sorry.
If you don't, I'm going.
Johnny. Is it worth it?
Yeah.
Man.
I'll go alone then.
Okay, but don't make me be the guy who bitched out.
I know it's sketchy.
I'm already cold.
We'll be in the forest. We got it, man. I know you don't want to do it, man. It's that black. Like, it's dark, dark. You don't want to go? You don't have to go. You don't have to go.
Kate, Johnny, but you don't have to either.
I have to. I have to know what the answer of this, man. I got to figure it out.
Come on.
I have to
figure it out. It's not worth it.
I have to figure it out. I have to.
Okay, are you seriously going?
I'll go. It's fine.
Are you seriously going?
Yeah,
I can't go. I can't do it.
Then I'll go.
Okay, but you don't have to either.
I need to. I have to go.
Okay, I'm going back.
That's fine. Give me your mic pack and everything.
Okay, I'm sorry, man. I just...
give me everything you got.
I can't...
I gotta figure this out, man. Dude, this is gonna be fucking really sketchy.
Okay. You don't have to do it, though.
I'm going to do it, Jordan.
Yeah.
Give me the back. If I get fucking attacked by a bear, you don't have a phone.
Okay. 20 minutes, man.
20 minutes and what? Then you're coming?
And then I'm coming.
Hmm? Oh, this is fucked. Why do we do this stupid shit? I have to. Oh, okay. Fuck, dude. Okay. Okay, now I have a whole boatload of shit. Oh, f*** me, man. How am I supposed to do a sensory by myself? Scary part. Ow. I can't see anything. only see the path based on what I'm seeing in the night vision. It's not a lot. I don't even want to see this building again.
I think what Johnny's doing is kind of stupid. But I mean, I get it. Like, when you really, really want to know something, you're really curious, then you'll do anything. I personally don't think it's worth it. I think, you know, in the context of what we're doing, we want to make a good video, a good paranormal video. And I think whatever happened tonight is good enough for that. But just traveling like way out there in the middle of the night when we're already way out here, like, we're not even close to civilization right now, and he wants to go even further to a place where he finds a pentagram.
Fuck me.
It's like I'm sitting here wondering when the hell he's gonna come back. How long am I gonna be waiting here? Is something gonna come for me here? A sitting duck here too.
Somebody just walked on the path behind me.
Yeah, I just hope he gets back all right.
Obelisk on. Fear.
Yeah, very scared. Very, very scared. Is something here with me?
I told him 20 minutes. I just want to go grab him every single second.
Are you what was in the cabin? Can't see anything. Can you tell me what your name is? Let me know who you are. My name's Johnny. Okay, everything's shutting off. Nope. Done. Yeah, done. Everything's shutting off. Cameras are shutting off. Okay, this camera shut off. Okay, we are out of here now. Nope, that is done. I can't see anything because I don't have night vision anymore. I just saw something come through that fucking window. Okay, that's game over for me. No. I don't know where I'm going. I can't see anything. Nope, that is the end of it for me. I saw somebody standing in the window. Yeah. Yep. Turn. Okay, I'm not turning. Okay, I gotta turn. Turn the light on my phone. Okay. I need to calm down. I don't know where I'm going. Oh. Reveal. No. Turn the f***ing obvious off. No. Oh. I heard that. Somebody's running behind me. Fuck off, man.
Oh, I think he's coming.
Fuck that.
Yeah, he's coming.
Holy fuck.
Are y'all good?
No.
Okay, get in.
Man, I was standing inside. Doing like, I couldn't do sensory.
What?
Okay, I couldn't do sensory, right? So I was doing an ovulus test. I'm standing inside the f***ing thing. And my camera just shuts off. Brand new battery. It's still going now. It just shut off. And I ran away and it started saying things to freaking me out. Like, and I heard somebody walking behind me up the path. Never again. Never, ever again. That was the most f***ing insane thing I've ever experienced in my life.